be it for giving project overview in college or demonstrating plans and visions at office conferences, we often need help of a projector. And the scope of a projector does not quite end there. Some projectors are also used as home theaters. And in recent days, projectors are becoming very popular on live screenings and grand events with a huge mass of people. So for their portability and widespread use, people's need for projectors is growing at a rapid pace. Since it is getting so popular, we thought, why not do some reviews on it? However, there are so many tech jargons associated with projectors, so we thought we should get started by simplifying those terms and helping people decide which is the best for them. And for that very purpose, we took three projectors from BenQ. And in this video, we will try explaining those terms taking these three projectors at reference. So let's get started. While choosing a projector, one of the very first things you need to keep in mind is the throw ratio. The throw ratio is the ratio between the throw distance and the width of the image. The throw distance is the distance between the projector and the screen or wall you are projecting in. But what does a throw ratio imply? If a projector casts a big image while keeping it closer to the projector surface, then it is called a short throw projector. However, if a projector requires a long distance to cast a big image on the surface, then that kind of projector is called a long throw projector. If you have a small meeting or conference hall, then a short throw projector can be a good fit. However, a long throw projector would be a fine choice if you have to install a projector in large classrooms. But how would you know if a projector is a long throw projector or a short throw projector? You may wonder, right? It's really simple. Just look at the throw ratio of the projector on its spec sheet. If the throw ratio is less than 1, then it is a short throw projector. Otherwise, it's a long throw projector. Usually, short throw projectors come with a throw ratio of 0.6 to 0.8. But if you are looking for an ultra short throw projector, you should go looking for a throw ratio of 0.4 or less. And if you're looking for a projector for home theater, you should determine the size and contour of the theater room. If the lens of your projector has a fixed focal length, then you will need to adjust the position of your projector to adjust the size of the image on the screen, and that can be frustrating at times. Among the three projectors we have, the BenQ MX731 and W1090 can zoom up to 1.3 times, whereas the BenQ TK800M can only zoom up to 1.1 times. So if other things are ignored and you only focus on the zoom, then you will get better flexibility with the ones having variable focal length, like the formal ones I mentioned. You can alter the size of the image without moving an inch of the projector. So if you are getting a new projector, make sure it has a zoom capability. Although all projectors may look similar in design, but the projection technique they use to project image on the screen may vary from one projector to another. There are mainly three types of projecting techniques used by projectors. They are DLP, LCD, and LED. Let's talk about DLP technology first. DLP, or Digital Light Processing Technique, uses millions of microscopic mirrors to generate an image. Each mirror is associated with a light point, and the mirror corresponds to the source with a tilting movement depending on the color of the light it's emitting. Since a mirror is microscopic and the movement is so subtle, the movements are not visible to naked eyes. The advantage with the DLP projectors is that they can deliver sharp images, they don't need any filters, they have better response time, and can project 3D images. However, most of the DLP projector comes with color ghosting effect. Also, the effective life of a lamp on a DLP projector is only 2000 to 5000 hours. So, there is that. Since the DLP projectors use microscopic mirrors, it requires relatively smaller spaces. That's the reason why modern-day ultra-portable projectors come with DLP technology. On the other hand, LCD projectors use liquid crystal displays, so no moving parts are involved while projecting an image into the screen. Even on the LCD category, you can find one chip and three chip LCDs. Single chip LCD is the most basic type of LCD projecting technology, which is used mostly on inexpensive projectors. On the other hand, three chip is a more sophisticated type. It offers better color saturation, lower noise levels, and works better for the movies. However, LCD projectors output less contrast and require constant filter maintenance. So there is a fair bit of trade-off as well. Talking about LED projectors, they use physical light emitting diodes. Since the LEDs are proficient when it comes to portraying deeper blacks, the contrast ratio is usually impressive on those. Since LED projector consumes less power, generates less heat, delivers better colors, and has a long lifespan, they are usually the best in the business. However, these kinds of projectors have limited brightness, so we do not recommend it in rooms with a lot of ambient light. Since brightness is one of the most important aspects, let's talk about it now. Every projector has a light intensity while projecting an image onto the screen. They are generally specified in terms of ANSI lumens. Higher the value, brighter the images you can get. If you had to install a projector in the rooms with already an ambient light in them, you need to go for the one with a brighter one. In three of our models, the BenQ MX731 with a brightness of 4000 lumens is the brightest of all. The BenQ TK800M and W1090 have a brightness of 3000 lumens and 2000 lumens respectively. And just look at their projections, you can find the differences right away. While looking for a projector, we might also come across this term, contrast ratio. The term actually describes the ratio of luminance of the whites to that of the blacks while portraying them on the screen. It means how bright the white part can look and how black the darker part looks on the screen. So higher the contrast ratio, higher will be the depth in the scenes and the dark scenes will also look lively. Although contrast ratio may not be that of an important factor while choosing a general purpose projector, but it is very crucial while you're choosing a home theater projector, so you need to focus on that as well. Now let's talk about one of the major aspects in a projector. It's obviously the resolution. Resolution determines how sharp an image can look while casting it on a big screen. Usually in school, colleges, and in offices, projectors are generally used to show PowerPoint presentations, so it might not matter that much. So even the low-res XGA projectors like the BenQ MX731 can suffice your needs. But while watching a high-definition movie or casting the gaming screen of PlayStation or Xbox, having a high-definition projection is a must. So you should at least go for a full HD resolution. If you don't want any sorts of compromises in terms of sharpness, you can even upscale it to 4K Ultra HD resolution. If you are finding it hard to decide, the casting of these projections might give you a brief idea about the resolution. The lamp is an integral part of a projector, and you might find it strange hearing it for the first time, but the lamp of a projector has limited life. Generally, a projector has a life of 2000 to 4000 hours, and after completing one life cycle, the lamp needs to be replaced and it requires additional cost. So if you are going to use the projector on a daily basis, make sure that the lamp is more. In a typical LED or laser LED hybrid projector, the lamp life can get high up to 20,000 hours. But if you already have a projector and want to increase its life, then you can use various inbuilt lamp modes. In case of these projectors, there are Eco Mode, Smart Mode, and Lamp Save Mode, with which you can extend the lamp life from 4,000 to 15,000 hours. These modes actually lower the brightness level. So if you're okay with low brightness, you should try it more often. Although things like resolution, contrast ratio, and brightness levels primarily determine the quality of a projector remains inherently incomplete if it does not have sufficient input and output ports. A good number of RS232 ports and HDMI ports is necessary for better flexibility. For uncompressed and high bandwidth signal transmission, you might as well have to look for the projectors with MHL and HDCP ports. Some of the projectors also come with USB Type A, which lets you show your PowerPoint without the use of a laptop or PC. Some modern projectors also feature a wireless dongle with which you can cast the screen on your laptop or smartphone in a hassle-free way wirelessly. You can find such kind of port in the BenQ MX731 projector. Plugging in a wireless dongle and using the BenQ QCast app, you can display the contents on your smartphone or PC directly on the projector. For the easier operation of a projector does require a fair number of control buttons. In that case, the option to adjust the keystones, easy selection of the source, and the option to adjust the projecting table are necessary. Since the lamp has a fixed life and needs replacement after its lifespan, there must also be an option to view the period of operation of the lamp. So make sure your projector has such an option if you are planning to get one. While giving presentations, you might have to describe some points in an elaborated fashion. And in such cases, a projector with interactive features is really necessary. And a projector that is enabled with interactive features comes with an interactive pen. The interactive pen works like a stylus with sensors on them. Such kind of pens lets you draw on the projecting screen, so it will be easier to highlight those points. Some projectors also come with inbuilt speakers. If you are not planning to invest extra on soundbars after purchasing the projector, ensure that the inbuilt speakers produce loud, sharp, and crisp audio. Well, I hope I was able to explain well and you understood the things to consider before buying a projector for yourself. But if you're still having a hard time, do let us know in the comments below. We will surely reply to the comments and help you decide one. Till then, I am Pratima Adhikari and thank you for watching.